Hello friends and welcome to Digimento. Today we will be discussing a very, very important topic, that is recently the former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh has suggested certain steps to revive the Indian economy from the financial crisis. So we will discuss about those steps which were suggested by Manmohan Singh to revive the Indian economy. As we all know, during the 1991 financial crisis, one of the largest financial crises and also the most severe financial crisis that our country faced, it was him who suggested certain measures to revive the economy. So let's look into these steps to revive the Indian economy, which is suggested by Manmohan Singh in detail in this lecture. Let's begin. But before that, if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe to our channel and also share this video with your friends. And if you are preparing for GATE, NTA, UGC NET or PGT Computer Science, we are providing online courses which you can avail. You can visit our website or you can call to this number to get the details about the online courses that we provide. So let's begin. So first, let's have a introduction about Manmohan Singh. Most of you must be already having a very good knowledge about him. He is a very renowned person, not only as a former Prime Minister, but in different field he is very much renowned. So let's have a quick introduction. So he is an Indian economist and he is also an academician and also a politician. He served as the 13th Prime Minister of India from 2004 to 14, the first Sikh in the office of Prime Minister and also the first Prime Minister since Jawaharlal Nehru to be re-elected after completing a full 5-year term. So after Jawaharlal Nehru, now we know that we have another Prime Minister also who has been selected or re-elected after a full 5-year term. So the present Prime Minister as well. Now he was the 13th Prime Minister. Manmohan Singh was the 13th Prime Minister of India. He was the chief economic advisor from the period 1972 to 76. He also served as the governor of the Reserve Bank of India from 1982 to 85. And he also was the head of the planning commission from 1985 to 87. So from this brief introduction about Manmohan Singh, we know that he is, apart from a politician, he is also an academician, he is an economist, and also he has held various key roles in the government of India as the chief economic advisor, as the governor of Reserve Bank of India, also as the head of the planning commission. Next, let us also quickly understand about the slowdown of Indian economy. Now, what does this slowdown basically means? So this slowdown, it basically means that the Indian economy's growth rate is going down. So here the slowdown refers to the growth rate or a decrease in the growth rate of Indian economy. Now, how is the growth of an economy measured? It is measured in terms of its GDP or gross domestic product. So slowdown of Indian economy here means that the GDP of the country is coming down. So GDP growth of Indian economy has touched the 6-year low in the first financial quarter. Now we need to know about the financial quarter. Every financial year in India begins from 1st of April. So from April 1st and it ends on 31st of March. So this is one financial year in India. And each financial year is divided into 4 quarters: Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. So each quarter containing or consisting of 3 months each. So first quarter is from April, May, June. So in the first quarter of this present financial year, we have witnessed the GDP growth to be a 6-year low. And what could be the reason? So the first quarter means from April onwards, April, May and June. So basically these 3 months, India has experienced a very low growth rate in GDP, primarily because of the national lockdown. This lockdown was imposed due to the outbreak of COVID-19 pandemic. So because of the subsequent lockdown, the country has experienced a very high fall in the growth rate in terms of GDP. The economic activities of the country almost came to an end during the month of April, during the lockdown, and later also the momentum was very less, that they did not pick up the growth. The COVID-19 pandemic and the continuous lockdown of Indian economy since March 2020 has further slashed the economic growth. So the economic growth was further slashed due to the continuous lockdown. International Monetary Fund, which is the IMF, has projected the growth, GDP growth of Indian economy at 1.9%. So IMF has forecasted that the growth of Indian economy during this financial year will fall to 1.9% because of the slowdown in economic activities. Now let's come to the impact of economic slowdown. So what can be the impact of this economic slowdown? The key sectors bearing the brunt of Indian economy slowdown are agriculture, automobile, real estate and FMCG. So FMCG is fast moving consumable goods. So these are the key sectors which has witnessed a major fall. The weaker consumer demand and slowing private investments is another factor. Consumer demand. When the demand falls, what will happen? The production also will fall. The supply will fall consequently to meet the lesser demand. So Indian economy is basically a demand driven economy, and when the demand for the goods reduces, definitely the supply or the production will reduce, which means the output will reduce or the GDP will reduce. Second factor is slowing private investments. The private investors or the capitalist has lost the confidence in the economy, that they are now not willing to invest further. The eight core sectors, the eight core industries, they have registered a negative growth of just 2.1% in the month of July compared to 7.3% in the corresponding month last year. So here we will see that the core sector, the performance of the core sectors also very low. The FPI, foreign portfolio investors, they have pulled out a net amount of 5,920 crores. So this is the impact of the economic slowdown overall on the economy. Next, we will see the suggestions given. His email interaction with the BBC. So his email interaction means Manmohan Singh's email interaction with the BBC. Economic slowdown in the country is a humanitarian crisis. So according to him, it is a humanitarian crisis. Government's shock and awe approach to the lockdown has caused tremendous pain to people. So government's shock and awe approach to the lockdown, they have caused a tremendous pain to the people. The suddenness of the announcement, that is, the lockdown was announced very suddenly without giving much information earlier. So the suddenness of the announcement and the stringency, the lockdown was very stringent in case of India. The stringency of the lockdown were thoughtless and insensitive. So these are all the conversations. And these are the three steps given to revive the Indian economy. So let's see what are the three steps. The first one, the government must ensure people's livelihoods are protected and they have spending power through significant direct cash assistance. So here he talks about DBT, direct benefit transfer or direct cash transfer to the beneficiary's account to ensure that the livelihoods are protected. So livelihood means the basic necessities of life, like the food, shelter and water and clothing. So these are the basic necessities of life and this has to be protected, and for that the government has to ensure that the livelihood, that is the source of income or source of livelihood of the people, are protected and they have the spending power. People have spending power through some direct cash assistance to the people. Second one, the center must also make adequate capital available for business through government backed credit guarantee program. So this is the second step, that is the government should provide capital to the business. So the businesses has slowed down because of the issue of this lockdown and because of COVID-19 outbreak. So the businesses, especially the small businesses, are thriving hard to find capital for reviving the business. So government should take steps to make the capital available for the business, and this can be done through government-backed credit guarantee programs. So government can provide credit guarantees for the loan that these businesses take. This is a second step. Third one is the government should fix the financial sector through institutional autonomy and processes. So third suggestion is regarding the financial sector, that is the banking and finance sector of the country. So how can the government fix the problems in banking and finance sector? This can be done through providing institutional autonomy. The financial institutions must be given autonomy to take their own decisions. So these are the three steps given, or the three solutions to revive the economy. First one, the first step, it pertains to the basic necessities of life, or rather we can say livelihood of the people. Second one, regarding businesses, to provide the businesses with adequate capital. Third one is regarding the financial sector, the banks and the financial institutions. So the financial sector, the banks or the financial institutions should be given autonomy to take their own major decisions. So these are the three steps suggested by him. So if you like the video, please do share this video with your friends and like this channel, like this video, and also subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon. Thank you so much for watching.